Hello, everyone. Dr. Surendra Manjrekar. Hello, how are you? First of all, my name is Bernardo Tutican. I'm from Brazil. Good morning to everyone. Here now is 9 a.m. First of all, I want to thank, it's a great honor to be here to give this speech to with this invitation, this kind of invitation of my friend Surendra. In this very important event, the post-COVID event. So thanks to everyone. My name is Bernardo Tutican. As I said, I will present about how new and durable concretes can improve the structure service life with low maintenance cost. We, with this COVID and even before the COVID, we need to prepare better structures with greater service life with low maintenance cost. It's important to our structures, mainly in our countries like Brazil, India, and developing countries, that you have few money to maintenance costs. So when we built a bridge, when we built a building, we need that structures, they need to have a great service life with low maintenance costs. So these concretes that I will present to you or improve your knowledge about them, is concrete with this main goal. So I will present. This is my email, bftutikian@unisinos.br. You can send me messages, you can send me some questions. I'll be online on the time that we agree with Dr. Surendra. So it's nice to be here. Thanks a lot. The first concrete I will introduce to you, it's the textile reinforced concrete, the TRC. The textile concrete is a fabric manufacturing process to guarantee the same rate of reinforcement over the entire length of the material. So we will guarantee the reinforcement of concrete in the direction of the main stress. So this is the picture. We will replace the steel reinforcement by this textile reinforcement. So we won't have corrosion process. We will have a structure of greater service life, because the corrosion is our main problem in the entire world, the main pathology in concrete structure. So this attempt is a way to avoid this problem in our structures. So you put a cement matrix to involve the textile reinforcement. So this cement matrix will protect this material. So this is a comparing of some options of structures. The first the picture in the left, my left, it's the first option, the reinforced concrete, the conventional reinforced concrete. We will put the rebars, in one direction on the main reinforcement, on the main loads necessity, but just on the one part of the concrete. The fiber concrete with small fibers, so you put these fibers on the entire piece surface. So we distribute better, it's a better distribution of the loads on the piece. It's an improve, but the textile concrete, as I said, we can put the textile just on we need on just when you need here the textile. So it's a very interesting which kind of textile we can use. the fiberglass, the glass fibers alkali resistance, the AR is the alkali resistance. The matrix, the cement matrix, is very alkaline. So we need to have a fiber with alkaline resistance. So we can put the glass fiber or the carbon fibers. We have other options like the basalt fibers and other kind of fibers, but these two are more commercial options. The glass fibers are present the glass fibers present worst properties than the carbon fibers, but the glass fibers are cheaper. So the market nowadays is using more the glass fibers than the carbon fibers. So, but both of them are very interesting. They have higher modulus than the matrix, so the matrix crack, and then the fibers could work. So it's a very nice option. These some sets options for the market. First, the number A, it's a glass. It's a glass textile with 3 and 5 centimeters of space. The second one is a carbon, is a better than the glass, but it's more expensive. And with 7 plus 7, the space. And the other one is 4 to 4. So the third one, the C, the C textile is better than B, and it's better than the A. So it's very easy, it's very flexible. We can adjust the textiles with our necessity very, very easy. So just to compare, the first one is the reinforced steel, the regular reinforced steel that you use in our structures with 600 megapascal tensile. This we use in our structures. Just to you see the glass the our other textiles, for example, the green one, the glass fiber with the resin styrene butadiene. It's not a very very good resin, very not good textile, and even though it's 1100 MPa, it means almost double of the reinforced steel, the regular reinforced steel. So it's much better, much more appropriate to our structures. If you change the resin to epoxy resin, the blue one, still with the glass fiber, 1300 MPa, much better. If you use the carbon fiber, look, 2000 MPa, and 3,200 MPa if you use the carbon fiber and epoxy resin, the best option that we have nowadays in a regular market. So much better than our conventional option of steel reinforced. So our cementitious matrix should have high fluidity because we need to involve the textile. And without voids, we need to have a mesh opening bigger than 2 to 3 times the maximum grain size of the matrix. In the harder state, we have more than 50 MPa of compressive strength and 4 MPa of tensile strength. It means it's a very good matrix, very good matrix. This is the behavior in a tensile. You just see very fast the stage A. This is the matrix job, the modulus of elasticity of the matrix until the point A when you have the first crack. So you can see in the picture the tensile will provide the strength. So when the tensile cracks, we use the matrix again and the tensile again. So It's a very very normal damage with no problem. Yeah, this some curves of load and displacement, very interesting. We design the structure between the stage one and two, yeah, because you need that point, the point A of when we pass the stage one to two is a critic stage, very interesting. So this is the bending behavior. Looking the a lot of cracks appear very distributed, very well distributed. So it's very interesting this behavior. As we have a much better material, look at the steel. This publication. Look at the steel. If 5.9 moment in this issue with 8 millimeters of thickness, 8 millimeters to give us 5.9 of resistance. To compare with textile concretes, we can use a carbon textile with 3 layers. In 40 millimeters or in 50 millimeter a basalt textile with 2 layers. Look, we can reduce the thickness of the structure to 8440, just to give you an example. We don't need a concrete cover because we don't have the corrosion. So some utilizations in the road, this material is widely used in German nowadays. So this is the Dresden University. They use this concrete, this tensile concrete for facades, panels, very interesting, with 1.3 meters and 2 meters, and with 30 millimeters of thickness. So very interesting, very nice structure. This walkway of 15.5 meters, so with carbon fibers, here is carbon fibers, the last example was glass fiber, here is carbon fibers, very interesting, a structural walkway. This is the cover of one built in the Aachen University, so in German again. So this is some examples. We have very nice structures, very, very, very efficient, and this is a future concrete with low maintenance. Another one is the self-healing. The self-healing, we can self-healing the problems. You can fulfill the cracks with materials that the own concrete will produce. So we can have a biologic producer, we have a chemical option, we have some options to self-healing the cracks that will form in concrete. It's very natural for concrete structures to appear cracks. So we need this, and in these cracks the bad agent could enter in concrete, so it's very important to seal, to close the ceilings to not have this option. We have these two mechanisms, the autogenic and autonomous. So the autogenic is when we use the cement or pozzolans with a chemical reactions to produce materials that will fill, that will occupy that space, that gap. So this is natural. You have this kind of autogenic mechanism in the all of our concretes, but this is not very efficient. It's just for small cracks, very small cracks. It's not important for the real situations. The real situations, we need to use another materials to external materials to help the concrete to be the self-healing. So you can use chemical solutions, bacterial solutions, PSA. You can use materials of shape memory, materials to the use of vascular networks or nets, and you can use the crystallizing additives. This is the autogenic, as I said. The pozzolan reacts with the calcium hydroxide and reacts the and formates the CSH. So this is, we know, this is the already happens with the concrete. But we can use some autonomous, like the bacterial solutions. The bacterial, you produce materials and you live, and the bacterials you work just when the crack opens and enter water. The water is very necessary for that reactions. So we can use the vascular nets to multiply the healing phenomena by the entire concrete. Now we can use these vascular nets for transport the self-regenerate agents. So, for example, this kind of solution, we will put the vascular nets in the entire surface of the concrete. So it's very efficient because we can have the agent, the self-healing agent, in the entire part of the concrete. But the problem is very difficult to build this in a real structure. We use this just in lab situation, so this is not very used in the nowadays in the structures. The crystallizing additives is the best option nowadays. They are products, commercial products, that they have the self-healing agent. They have including the calcium in the product, so the agent could the self-healing agent could react with this calcium and can form the crystalline products and close all the pores, all the cracks, all the problems that you have. It's an occurrence of cracking and water penetration. The water activates the crystalline catalyst. So we need the water. It's very important. We need the water. And this is, we can use also some chemical solutions inside the clay, for example, inside some expanded clay particles that you can put inside the concrete, and you can use this also. This is some applications in Brazil. We use the self-healing concrete in some museums here near the ocean, with a lot of chloride ions on the air. So you can, we use this in very normal structures nowadays, but it will be a very, it will improve their use in the next years, I'm sure. Some case studies here in Unicinos, we impregnate the expanded clay with sodium silicate. This is the process, and what you see, we can find the these products, these self-healing products, less than 28 days after the crack. So it's very fast. In 20 days, you can feel the crack. Now, cracks of 160 and 135 micrometers. So you can feel these cracks just 1 month after the crack opens. This is some micro pictures to find the chemical compounds. Very interesting, very, very clear. Né? Some results with bacteria. The bacteria improve the compressive strength, and decrease the water penetration depth. So it's very interesting. This is studies to check the current condition. The first two, very good condition, water immersion, water control, 100 of clay crack closure, 100. So, but if with no water, no water in in very great amount, like in a humid chamber or air exposure, no crack closure. So we need water to give this reaction. We need water. So look at the dimensions, the study of the dimensions with 0.3 millimeters. It's a very good crack to fill, to close. 0 days, 5 days, 15 days, 20 days, almost done. 20 days, very fast, almost done. But with 0.8, 20 days, almost nothing done. This is a problem. We cannot fool the big cracks. Until 0.5, it's okay. So this is our maximum crack seal, is up to 0.5. This is a gap of the study nowadays. This is a good, very good crack, 0.5. I don't know if we need to seal cracks upper than this, but this is what we need. We can do until now. We have to study more the feasibility of self-healing products over time, the adhesion of the self-curing product with the existing concrete. We don't know this kind of the quality of the self-healing product in 10 years, 20 years. This is studies that we are doing in this right time. The efficiency of different self-healing mechanisms in common concrete exposure environments. We need water to open these reactions. So thanks very much. Thanks for your attention. I have to hurry up very fast, but I think we could present these two very interesting concretes that will improve their use in the next years. Mainly now with this COVID effect, that we need to build better structures with better service life, with greater service life, with low maintenance costs. So we try to explain this to you today. If you want to send me an email, this is my email, and I'm available to change experience and to answer some questions. So thanks very much, my friend Surendra.